Today's video has been brought to you by She Clothing.
Satan, I hope you got your winter clothing.
Yes, don't adjust your screen. Hell officially froze over. Hey, what's going on, everybody? It's Kazama Fury here. And like I said months ago, put out a better kit. And I am a collector. I know it fought against every part of my being, but I got the system. And I can tell you one thing. I ain't pick up Breath of the Wild. And I'm kind of... like I said, the only game I'm really interested in is coming out in a couple of weeks, really. And that's Odyssey. Super Mario Odyssey. That's probably the only first party game at the current moment that I'm interested in. But I finally complete the three. I had the three last gen systems. I mean, I had, for Pete's sake, I had, at the time being, I had a GameCube, I had an Xbox original, I had a PlayStation 2, next generation, 360, PS3, Wii, and Wii U. I don't know, it kind of mixes up. Those two kind of fall in the same generation. Like, the Wii and the Wii U were pretty much ran the life cycle collectively together. Ran the life cycle of the the 360 and the the PS3. My mind is the morning time. I ain't eat yet, you know. I do this intermittent fasting, and sometimes your mind goes places unless you have you hydrate and stay good. That's how I lost all the body fat and stuff, but that's a different topic. Anyway, so now I complete the trilogy of the current generation. Reluctantly, because I'm very selective of what I buy for all three systems. Like, I feel like with the Xbox One, which doesn't have much first party games, but it gives you a lot. It gives you your back catalog to play. It gives you stuff from your back catalog you never got to play. It's gonna give you the original Xbox games coming soon, so that's its strength. That's pretty much its only strength it has right now. As for the PS4, everybody's going gaga over these exclusives, but let's keep it real here. They have right now, they just doing what the 360 did in the last generation. Play this first on this system. But then they got like things like Horizon Zero Dawn, which I've watched play, and I'm like, it's good, but it's not all that, you know. God of War 4 is coming. Now that I'm gonna pick up, you best believe, you bet your ass I am. But I don't know, maybe it's just me. Maybe lately it's like, because we've been talking, like, people in this gaming community who are, how do the pro-blacks say, woke, have seen a lot of shit. Like, we know. Now, I'm gonna do another video. I'm not gonna even mention any of the Capcom games, because that's another video coming. But we've been dealing with incomplete games, downloadable content, passing itself off as downloadable content when it's actually the part to finish the game, heightened difficulties behind paywalls, which Nintendo's infamous for, which all of the system, all the developers are starting to do, you know? So we can't really condemn Nintendo alone on that. But this is the company that was built by Mario, and you wouldn't think, of all companies, you wouldn't think they would be the ones. But yo, I guess cash is always been king, And now we starting to see a lot of people, a lot of companies doing this shit. But anyway, back to what I was saying about it. Yes, I own the Switch now. And I can tell you the two games I have. Real quick. Sonic Mania, this Gaia 5. Complete. Boom. Just like that. And maybe Mario in a couple of weeks. That's about it. Yes, I say Mario because of my accent. I know it's Mario. Anyway. Let's talk about the next topic I have right there. And it says Nintendo restricts live streaming on YouTube. Yes, for your partners program, the YouTube creators program that they got, you can't live stream. You can put together videos that are short and montage things and show quick gameplay things, but you can't live stream. They don't want you to do that. And I can kind of understand why. They want their games to sell, all right? I mean, look at Resident Evil 7. Why you think it's not selling? People got to see this game for the absolute shit it is. When I say shit, I don't mean it's terrible. It's just shit compared to the past Resident Evil games. Even the action-based ones have a fan base better than this one. You know, but like I said, that's another video. But anyway, maybe. Did that hurt the sales of RE7? I doubt it. You know what hurt the sales of RE7? Fucking first person. Fight me. Anyway, so Nintendo restricts live streaming. And who's a long time Nintendo fan? Are you even surprised anymore that they would do something like that on YouTube? Like, YouTube is a mess today, and thank God I don't do this as a career. That's why my videos come far and few between, you know? I don't do this as a career. I'm a blue-collar gamer. What do you think I make my money doing? Work. I'm working for a man. I'm not looking for this as a second income or anything like that. So, they restrict them. They don't want people to see too much of the game. They want you to see just enough so you can go buy it. I get it. And stuff. You know, me, usually I'll be like, oh no, there's no way for me to, like, I can't point fault at them for that. Think about it. Like, with this company, are we giving a track history, given that they hate fan projects, given that they will shut shit down immediately? We not even mad anymore about it. We not. What can you be mad about? The only thing I could be mad about is that I actually made the plunge and bought the system finally. And a lot of this stuff fall through. Like, they don't have, like, I'm not expecting. I'm seeing a lot of companies are getting behind this thing and stuff. But I'm not one of those Skyrim nerds that think, oh my God, I can finally play Skyrim. I had all the means to play it in the past. I got all the fucking consoles, technically, of the last few generations. So I'm not buying it for that or the other stuff. I mean, I can go out and buy Doom right now, pre-owned for $17.99, probably cheaper because I have I'm a pro member at GameStop, and you get discounts and they always got coupons and shit for us. So that's not why I'm buying it. Is it for the portability? No. Kind of. I think I could find myself playing Sonic more than anything, because Sonic is a game that pretty much functions off of jump. It's a platformer that functions off of jump and direction button. Pretty much all you got to do is time it, avoid enemies, which is technically impossible to do unless you, like, and given the speedy manner of having to play the game, you get 10 minutes. And the stage is just so robust, meaning, like, there's so much hidden stuff. There's so many different paths to go and stuff. So, you can always, that's where its replay value go, because you can always get through it a different way. Sometimes you make one mistake and you back down to the old path and you find another. There's always another way, and it's all about timing. And if you want to avoid every spike, everything, that means you can't go fast. The game's about going fast. You're going to take damage. So Sonic Mania and Disgaea 5 are the two I got. I could play Sonic Mania. I could play Disgaea 5 even on the go. Because I could even do that, but Sonic is, those are the type of games I could play on the go. Something like that. Like platformers. As long as they need to open up that virtual arcade ASAP. There's no way in hell that I have to settle with playing on the Wii U for virtual arcade. And watch, they make you pay for your, I think they are. They said they are. I said that before, that they said you're gonna have to pay a fee each game to download it onto the Switch. That's fucked up. That is fucked up. And I can tell you why it's fucked up. Microsoft. Big shot, Microsoft. You know, that's far behind PlayStation 4, Microsoft. All the stuff I bought on my 360 arcade. Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles game, which I have to re-download. I forgot all about it. No, it is downloaded on there. It started downloading on itself. Shinobi, the game of nightmares, that game. If you watch my Twitch, you understand that me and Shinobi, we ain't seeing eye to eye right now. But all this stuff, Gogan, even the Fable I got when I had the 360, Fable 2, the free download, moved over to the one. Did I pay nothing? I paid nothing to have it moved. So that's a dick move. That is a really dick move, Nintendo. All the things and stuff. That is a dick move. But anyway, you might see a review or two coming for a Switch game. Just because it's the system newest to me. It's more of a, it's foreign territory. So you might see something for that coming soon. But anyway, keep watching what you want. Keep gaming the way you want. Keep being you, because I'm a Fury. I'm out. If you are a Switch fan, let me know if something that I should experiment with that's not cutesy and childish on the Switch. Give me a game that's not cutesy and childish. I'll wait. Anyway, peace.